Hey guys, it's James Walkup with TurnkeyInvest.com and Foundation Property Management here in Memphis, Tennessee. Do you have rental property in Memphis? If so, this video is for you. If you consider selling your property, there's things you need to take into mind. Are you going to hire a realtor off, you know, just from any brokerage who doesn't really live and breathe the investment world like we do, or a seasoned veteran, 2 decades of living and breathing investment properties like our team to get you top dollar for that property? Because if you're considering selling a property in Memphis, Tennessee, and it's an investment, you need somebody on your side who knows how to sell investment properties. Take care of everything up front so that there's no surprises on the back end, so that you get more money in your pocket, net proceeds, at closing than just hiring any typical realtor. So here I've got a little comparison, what it looks like to hire a typical agent. And I'm not definitely not talking bad about any agents. There's just 3,500 agents in Memphis. Out of 3,500, only 300, 10%, sold enough real estate to be in the multi-million dollar club. To quantify that, to be in the multi-million dollar club, you need to sell around $3 million worth of property. Selling $3 million worth of property is easy to do. You can do that as a part-time job. And most realtors in Memphis, I would say overwhelming majority, real estate is not their only profession. This is the only thing I do. I don't even have hobbies. This is, I live, eat, breathe real estate, and then my family time. But our team was the number one selling property management company, investment brokerage in Memphis, Tennessee at $18 million in sales. I don't say that to brag, but to impress upon you that this is all we do. I don't list million-dollar homes. I don't even list my neighbor's house when they sold it. I am an investment broker. This is what we do. So let me show you the comparison between the two. Net funds in your pocket. That's what everybody's big question is, all right, who's going to get me more money? So selling with a typical agent, it's about 30% less in your pocket than selling with us. And I'm going to explain why we can get you 30% more net in your pocket. So the commission structure is where we'll start, but it's not the most important thing. I'm not a commodity provider. If you're looking for a cheapest price, I'm not the guy. We charge $5,000 flat rate fee. So on a $50,000 investment property, I might not be your guy, first of all. A $50,000 house, that's a 10% commission. You probably need a 10% commission to sell a $50,000 house. That means it's in a rough neighborhood and in horrible condition in today's environment. But a 6% commission on a $180,000, $200,000 home, it takes me as much work to sell a $50,000 house as it does a $500,000 house. We're 5% flat rate fee because it's the same amount of work for me and my team to go through our process, our proven process, get your home sold, put more money in your pocket. So no percentages, a flat rate fee. Now, another part of this is I'm always finding ways for me to be more in alignment with my clients. When you're selling a property, I shouldn't be rewarded, you know, heavily. This is your exit out of the market. And it's just what we do. We put you in our process. It's in our system. We have buyers begging for properties. That's another point we'll get to. So when you are looking to exit the market, we're not looking to make a big gain. It costs me about $2,500 to actually sell a house between man hours and all the things that come involved there. Rent in my building, you know, overhead. All you business owners know that. So we're not making a windfall here. We're looking to offer this as a service. All right, so selling a house, typically you're gonna pay about 2% in closing cost. I have a system put together, reach out to me and the team more, where you're gonna pay about 1% in seller closing cost. So on a $200,000 home, we just saved you another $2,000. Inspection and contingencies. So when you list your house with a typical realtor, let's say the house is occupied. And that's a really hard thing for most realtors to do, is sell a tenanted cash flowing house. We're like, why? That should be easier. Well, getting in the house for multiple inspections, which we'll talk about in a minute. Too often on the multiple listing system, homes for sale, I see the picture of the outside of the house. Sometimes it's blurry because the realtor is driving as they take the picture. And that's it. Oh, come on, guys. You can't sell a house for top dollar with one picture. You just can't do it. So inspection and contingencies. When you sell a house that has one picture on the MLS, most realtors are going to put in the verbiage, no showings available until we have an accepted contract. So they get it under contract, then they do an inspection, find out what they've got to sell. Well, now we've disrupted your person living there. We have multiple people coming in and out of the house. They're taking off work to meet the realtor so they can potentially look at the house to maybe buy it. Not a good thing. Financing contingencies. So I make an offer to buy your house, but it's contingent upon me being able to get a loan. Let's see if we can remove that. So we take care of selling with jameswalkup.com. There's none of this. We take care of this up front, and I'm going to show you how. Appraisals. Yes, the sale is subject to an appraisal. Selling with a typical agent, 25% of my buyers or more are cash buyers. That eliminates that. Even more of my buyers will come to you to buy your property because I've worked with them. I've shown them what they're buying and tell you that in the event of a low appraisal, they're willing to pay X amount over that low appraisal. So I'm looking at this for you guys as if I own the property myself. How would I sell it? Average days on market. A typical agent, you're looking at 90 days plus. With us, from beginning to close, 45 days is our average. So we are fast. And why are we fast? Because we've taken care of everything up front. Going to show you that. Number of showing. It depends with a typical agent. You just don't know. And if this is an occupied property that is scary to your resident, you might run them off. What are all these people coming in and out of my house for? And they're going to make me move when this house is sold. They have to take off work. A lot of my renters are hardworking people. They can't take off work and just casually come home to let a realtor who's late come show the house, or an inspector to come in for the third time and inspect the house. So selling a house with an occupied property with the tenant living there can be a very scary moment for the owner, that's you, and the resident living there. We eliminate that because there's only one showing, it's us. We show up, we're logoed up shirt, we have a reason for being there, we're in, we're out, we get what we need to market the home up front to eliminate all of this. All right, closing date. Once it's under contract with a typical agent, you're looking at about 60 days. In this position, you're in control. This is a seller's market. You all know that. You choose that, we'll establish that up front. Who pays for repairs with a typical listing? It's negotiated. Like, we'll find out. Well, what kind of repairs should I be expecting when you're talking to a typical realtor? I don't know. We'll figure it out as we're going through the process. No, let's take care of that up front. We're going to sell the property as is. So we're going to give a transparent look to the person buying the house. We're not going to sell them something they don't know what they're buying, but we're going to sell it the condition that we listed in. That way, when it comes time to close, there's no ambiguity. Well, I thought that the water heater was new, but it's really 85 years old. No, they're going to know what they're buying up front, and let me show you how. So our proven process to be the number one investment broker in Memphis, Tennessee, works like this. First of all, I have more than 10,000 people on my email list that, by the way, have not unsubscribed. So every email I send out, I always send out one email a week to my list of 10,000 investors from around the world. They all have the opportunity to unsubscribe, and they haven't. That list grows daily because daily people are reaching out to me saying, hey, I want to build a portfolio in Memphis, Tennessee. I've watched your videos. I like that you have everything under one roof that an investor needs to succeed, from acquisitions, renovations, home building, and property in-house property management, all here under this roof. That list is growing daily. So the house automatically goes to our website. And when a house is listed on my website, it gives an investor all the information they would need to make a decision whether this one is a possibility for their portfolio, or maybe it's not a fit. But they don't have to make a million phone calls finding that out. Maybe they're shopping at 2 a.m. my time because it's noon in Israel or Japan or Australia, where a lot of my buyers are. So from the website, they'll see the available properties. They can click the button that says view listing, and it opens up a more detailed page about the particular property they're interested in. They will see a map. They'll see down here a little bit more information. If they click this button that says go to due diligence vault, it opens up a folder with lots of great information, especially a savvy investor like a lot of mine are. Let's talk about what's in this folder. This is all the things you need for your due diligence. If I was buying a house out of state, this is what I would build. This is why I build it up front before we ever list it for my clients. And I do this hundreds of times per year. First of all, we're going to have a home inspection pre-listing. We're going to go out and send a third-party home inspector out there. I'm going to eat that. I'm going to pay for that up front, and I'll be reimbursed on the back end when we sell the property. That home inspection is going to bring a lot of clarity. It's going to say, look, we hired a third-party home inspector to go out there and give his unbiased opinion. This isn't James, that bald guy in Memphis, saying, it's a good property, nothing wrong with it, you should buy it. Of course, if the home inspector doesn't find anything, they should lose their license. They could find 25, 30 things wrong with my personal house right now. Home inspector should find some items that need to be addressed. Now we're giving a transparent look to our potential new buyers of exactly the condition of what they're buying. I'm going to give them two pro formas, a projected pro forma, which is how we're selling real estate in today's market, and an actual pro forma. But what's the difference? Actual pro forma, this house is rented for $300 a month, well under market value. The lease is coming up in November of 2022. At that time, based on today's rents, the projected pro forma is what we should be looking at. If you're buying commercial space and you've got a tenant that's been in there for 10 years, I guarantee you they're under rented. In the commercial world, you look at projected performance, actual performance, know where you are going into a deal and what the potential is. This is going to allow you to get a higher sales price in a hot market like we're in today, especially if you have a good property like the one we're looking at, meaning good condition, great resident, who's paying on time. I've got all this information already preloaded. So actual and projected performance is important. When they look at the pro forma, it's going to give them a breakdown of what they should expect financially with this property. So you have your projected and your actual. Then we're going to give them a three-up report. So what is a three-up report? This is what an appraiser would be looking at if they were to appraise the house in today's market. So you're always looking for homes that are in the same vicinity geographically, because if anyone ever sends you in real estate a comparable sale that's miles away from the property, that red flag should go up. So in the same vicinity, same square footage, bedroom, bathroom range, age range, and condition. Are these properties in the same condition as my property? Good, better, best, you might call it. If you have a house that's in really good condition, you should not be using a comparable sale that's across the street that needs $100,000 worth of renovations to be the caliber of your property. So right here up front, well, you're just shopping. You're getting all this information, not having to pick and choose and go and find these things. This allows us to find buyers for your property to pay top dollar and justify that decision logically with data. Then we're going to give you a rentometer report. So what is rentometer? This is one of the tools I use for gauging rents in the area. And it's based on true data, so comparable rents. We just talked about comparable sales. Now we're talking about comparable rents, because both are important in the world, in our world, aren't they? So this property, the average is $1,500 a month. And the top tier for the comparable rents in the area as high as $1,700 a month. I always like to stick with the average just to be conservative. But if you've got a really nice property, especially in a good area that people are attracted to for rentals, you can start looking between the average and the top tier, can't you? So this comes down, it gives you again, a map to show geographically, these properties are in the same vicinity. Then I sort these properties closest to furthest away, just like an appraiser would. And then we start looking at bedroom, bathroom, square footage, and we get a real easy picture here of what rents can be in the area for comparable homes, meaning bedroom, bathroom, square footage, condition, geographic location. Now we have true data about what this home should rent for. The home inspection, we've already got that before listing. We're going to be able to provide this. And there might be a time when we're listing your house where we say, look, let's go on out there and clean the gutters. Let's, you know, do some minor little touch-ups and then report to our potential new buyers that this work's already been done. Let's spend $500 now to keep from spending $5,000 once we get it under contract. So that's how our team is going to work with you to make sure that this is a seamless process. And then in the diligence vault, what else do we have? We have a letter from me and my family talking about who our company is that could be somebody that's never worked with us before. But the overwhelming message here is we have a process that works. We have a step 1 through 10 process that all of our buyers buy into, and it works time over time. And then in-house property management, meaning we can help you acquire the property. We can take care of any renovations, even a fire job, or if we build houses for investors as rentals. And then we manage it on the back end. You don't have to go and find 3 different companies to achieve that goal, which is a cash flowing property at the end of the day. You have one company who handles everything you need, no matter where you live, with great communication and full transparency. So Foundation Property Management, it talks about who we are, why we started this business. If you want to learn more about who we are, go to foundationpm.com for our property management. Go to turnkeyinvest.com and learn about us. We've got preferred lenders you can work with, a closing attorney that's part of our team, a hazard insurance group policy, and my team members who make this thing go round and round. I even give them a checklist for buying out of state. If you're buying a house out of state, you should start this checklist. Go through it. You know, go on my website. We'll give it to you for free. We don't hold this, you know, as a little jewel. We don't give out. I give this away for free. Let me just tell you, if I'd have used this checklist my entire career, there's about 5 houses I would not have bought because they were all in the flood zone. And that's on the checklist. Is the house in the flood zone? No. Where would you find that information? In my due diligence vault. So in the diligence vault, there's also a property data sheet. This is all the information that's provided to me as a real estate broker in the state of Tennessee, given to you, given to our potential buyers of your property. And at the very, it gives a lot of great information. Some people would say too much. It shows you the exact taxes straight from the source, not an estimate that we were giving out. Square footage, bedroom, bathroom count from multiple sources. Boom, very bottom, FEMA flood zone. This is not in a flood zone. Check it off your checklist. Move towards buying the house. If you've got a property that you're considering selling, a lot of my clients are doing 1031 exchanges. I've got clients who are simply done with investing. They've got a change in their life. Maybe they're going through a divorce or some financial issues. I've got one guy who sold all of his properties through our company and put it into a new business he started. He said, James, once I get that business up and going, I'll come back and buy more properties from you. But he needed some cash in hand. And right now, you can sell at top dollar. It's a seller's market. We're going to get you top dollar, 30% higher than just your typical realtor. We're going to do all the work up front. We're going to charge you a flat $5,000 rate fee by using all of our resources, our attorneys, and everything we've got in place. We're going to save you money on closing costs. It's a no-brainer. If you've got a house you want to sell in Memphis, Tennessee, reach out to me and the team, and we will get you the top dollar in your pocket, net proceeds from the sale. And make it easy. Have a good day.